Hello everyone. Depending on the type of construction and operation methods, the relays are classified into different types. They are electromagnetic relays, static relays, and microprocessor based relays. Electromagnetic relays are electromagnetic attraction type and electromagnetic induction type. Static relays uses semiconductor devices like ICs, transistors, diodes, logic gates, etc. There is no moving parts in static relays. Then microprocessor based relays uses microprocessors, and there will be suitable programs in the microprocessor for controlling the operation of relay. In this video, we will be discussing about electromagnetic relays. First one is electromagnetic attraction relays. There are three types: attracted armature type, solenoid type, and balanced beam type. In attracted armature type relay, it consists of a laminated electromagnet carrying coil C. And the armature is balanced by a counterweight at the bottom. Here there is an electromagnet and the coil. This is the armature balanced by the counterweight. Under normal condition, the current through the coil C will not energize the armature, or it will not attack the armature. It is balanced by the counterweight. This coil is connected to the line to be protected, or the apparatus to be protected, and it carries the current in the transmission line. When the fault occurs, current in the line increases, or current through the coil increases, and it will produce more attractive force, more than the counterweight, and the armature is attracted by the electromagnet. When the armature is attracted upwards, this strip circuit will get closed due to the spring arrangement. So, this completes the strip circuit, which results in opening of the circuit breaker and therefore disconnection of the faulty circuit. And the minimum current at which relay armature is attracted to close the strip circuit is called pickup value of current. The value at which relay operates can be varied by providing the number of tappings on the relay coil. Next type is solenoid type relay. Here also the principle is similar to that an attracted armature type, only difference is in the construction. It consists of a solenoid and moving iron plunger. And solenoid is wound with a coil which carries the current in the system to be protected. Under normal condition, there is no attractive force. Then fault occurs, the attractive force increases and iron plunger is attracted towards the solenoid and the trip circuit is get closed. This iron plunger is in position under normal condition by spring arrangement. When fault occurs, the force will be more than the spring force and the trip circuit is closed, and which operate the circuit breaker. Next type is balanced beam type relay. In this case, it consists of an iron armature fixed to a balanced beam. Under normal current condition, the current through the relay coil is such that the beam is held in horizontal position by the spring arrangement. When fault occurs, current through the relay coil greater than the pickup value and the beam is attracted towards the iron balanced beam is attracted towards the electromagnet and crosses the trip circuit, and hence operating the circuit breaker. Next, these three are electromagnetic attraction type relays. Next is electromagnetic induction relays. Its principle is similar to that of an induction motor. It is widely used in measuring or for protecting AC systems. It cannot be used with DC quantities. It consists of a pivoted aluminium disc between two alternating magnetic fields, phi 1 and phi 2. The torque produced in the disc by the interaction of one of the magnetic field with the current induced in the disc by the other. There will be flux current induced in the aluminium disc due to the two fluxes, and due to that the torque is induced in the aluminium disc. Two AC fluxes phi 1 and phi 2 differing in phase by an angle alpha induce EMF in the disc and cause eddy currents I1 and I2. In a circular disc, the current will be eddy currents. These currents lag behind their respective fluxes by 90 degrees. If two fluxes are with magnitude 5m max omega t and 5m max sin omega t plus alpha with a phase difference of alpha, then the torque developed will be phi 1 max, phi 2 max, sin alpha. So depending on the value of alpha, the torque will be increased. If the alpha is 90 degree, maximum torque will be produced. Different types of electromagnetic induction relays are shaded pole structure, whatever meter structure, and induction cup structure. Shaded pole structure, it consists of an aluminium disc free to rotate in the air gap of an electromagnet. And each half of each pole of the magnet is surrounded by a copper band known as shading ring. The alternating flux phi s in the shaded portion of the pole will lag behind flux phi u in the unshaded portion of the pole. So here there is a shaded pole, phi s flux produced in the shaded portion and phi u is the flux produced in the unshaded portion. Both fluxes will have a phase difference of alpha. The shading is done to get the phase difference. These two AC fluxes differing in phase will produce necessary torque to rotate the disc. The driving torque T is torque is proportional to phi s phi u sin alpha. The fluxes phi s and phi u are proportional to the current I in the relay coil. So torque is proportional to both currents, both fluxes are with the same current I only. So it is proportional to I square sin alpha. So driving torque is proportional to the current square. So it does not depends on the direction of current. And next is wattover meter structure. It is used in wattover meters. It consists of pivoted aluminium disc arranged to rotate freely between the poles of two electromagnets. The upper magnet carries two windings, the primary and secondary. The primary winding carries the relay current I1, while secondary winding is connected to the lower magnet. The I1 is the current to be actuated, current in the apparatus to be protected. And due to that current, a current I2 is induced in the secondary winding, and that current flows through the lower electromagnet also. The primary current induces EMF in the secondary and so circulates the current I2 in it. The flux phi2 induced in the lower magnet by the current in the secondary winding of the upper magnet will lag phi1 by an angle alpha. Depending on this arrangement, there will be flux phase difference of alpha between phi1 flux produced in the upper magnet and lower magnet. So there will be a driving torque of phi1 phi2 sin alpha, and depending on the driving torque the disc will rotate. And when the disc is rotating, the trip circuit is such that when the disc is rotating to certain angle, the trip circuit will get closed. Next is induction cup structure. It resembles like induction motor, except that the rotor ion is stationary. Only rotor conductor portion is free to rotate. The moving element is hollow cylindrical rotor which turns on its axis. The rotating field is produced by two pairs of coils wound on four poles. The rotating field induces current in the cup to provide necessary driving torque. So here there are four poles and two poles carrying having same flux, and the flux in other two poles will be at an angle alpha. So if phi 1 and phi 2 represent fluxes produced by the respective pair of poles, then torque produced will be phi 1 phi 2 sine alpha, where alpha is the phase difference. So and has very high speed. These are the different types of electromagnetic relays: electromagnetic attraction type and electromagnetic induction type. In the next class, we can see static relays and microprocessor based relays. Thank you.